Hello children, how are you? Fine, okay. You must obey your parents. You must eat healthy food. Stay home, stay safe. Today, I welcome you to the third standard science class. Our lesson is Mind Body. From that lesson, already you learnt how to wash our hands, using toilets and bathing. Now, let us learn protection of sense organs. How to help the disabled person. Next, importance of exercise. How to keep ourselves safe. Now we are going to see about these four topics. Our first topic is protection of sense organs. We know what are the sense organs. We have five sense organs. What are they? Eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin. These are five sense organs. What is the use of sense organs? The sense organs help us to observe and understand the world around us. The sense organs have some specific functions. What are the specific functions? So we see one by one. Eyes help us to see, ears help us to hear, nose help us to smell, tongue help us to taste, skin help us to feel. These are the specific function for sense organs. Now we want to see how to protect these sense organs. We want to see now one by one. First we want to see eye. We want to see now how to protect the eyes. By nature, the eyes has eyelids and eyelashes that protects eyes from the dust and foreign particles. But we want to do some activities for the protection of eyes, and we want to not do for some activities for the protection of eyes. What are the activities we want to do? What are the activities we don't? Please, you want to read it with a proper light. Don't reading too bright or too dim light. Watch TV from a minimum distance of 6 feet. Don't play video games and watch TV for a long time. If you have any irritating in your eyes, wash it with clean and cold water. Don't rub your eyes with your fist. Don't rub your eyes with your fist. See, if you find any difficult to read the classroom board from your place, you tell your teacher or parents to consult a doctor. You want to get suggestions from the ophthalmologist. Nowadays, most of the people have digital eye strain. Digital eye strain, because most of the people are working at computer. This condition leads dry eyes, eye strain, blurred vision, and headache. So when you go outside, you must wear sunglasses, because the sunglasses protect our eyes from the sun rays. Okay, next organ is ears. Ears help us to hear the sound. If you want to protect the ears, you avoid loud noise. Don't listen music at higher volume while using earphones or headphones. Don't clean your ears with earbuds. Use ear blocks or ear muffs when you expose the loud noise. Dry your ears after taking bath. Cover your ears while swimming. If you have any pain in your ears, you consult a doctor. Noise levels are measured in decibels. Noise levels are measured in decibels. Any sound over 85 decibels, that harmful to us. Hearing loss cannot be prevented always, but hearing loss due to exposure to a loud noise can be avoided. So likewise, you can protect your ears. Next sense organ is nose. Nose help us to smell and breathe. How to protect the nose? By nature, hair present inside our nose that helps to filter the dust when we breathe in. Don't clean your nose inside any foreign objects. When you black your nose because of cold, you better to steam to clear it. Don't pick your nose. When you sneeze or cough, you must use the handkerchief to cover your nose and the mouth, because it helps to prevent the spread of diseases. Then you want to use the mask. This helps to prevent the COVID-19 virus. Next organ is tongue. See, tongue helps us to taste the food. Thousands of taste buds are present in our tongue that help us to taste the food. Tongue is the muscular organ. How to protect it? You want to clean your tongue daily by using tongue cleaner when you are brushing. Dirty tongue causes bad breath. So clean tongue helps us to pronounce the words clearly. You must rinse your mouth. Must rinse your mouth after eating meals or snacks. It helps to cure some oral problems to us. Next organ is skin. skin help us to feel. It is the largest organ in our body, and also it is one of the excretory organ. The skin protects our internal organs also. How do you want to protect the skin? You want to use mild soap. Rub your skin gently with a clean cloth. If you have any infections or skin injury, you must consult a skin doctor. It is, now I said, how to protect the sense organs. If any problem for you, you want to consult the particular doctors. If you have any eye problems, you want to consult a ophthalmologist. If you have any problem for your ears, nose and tongue or throat, you go to ENT specialist. If you have any skin problem for you, you go to the dermatologist. Okay, please. Now I completed the how to protect the sense organ. Next, second one, how to keep ourselves safe. Now we want to see how to keep ourselves safe. Okay, please. Now you are going to garden. Many flowers and butterflies are there. You try to catch one butterfly. What happened? It flew away. Why? Because it did not like your touch. Otherwise, they want to escape from you. Likewise, we also have some problems. So, the touches are two types: good touch, bad touch, don't touch. Okay, what is good touch? Good touch is a touch that cares for us, make us feel safe. These are the examples for good touch. Father and mother pats on your head. Mother hugs you, shaking the hands. These are the examples for good touch. Okay, what is bad touch? Bad touch is a touch you don't want. You feel scared. That are bad touch. Examples for bad touch: slapping, beating, and hugging, kissing. These are examples for bad touch. Now, I will say three rules for you to how to keep yourself safe. Rule number one, it is never rights for anyone look at, touch or talk about your private part. And it is never rights for someone older than you to ask you to touch, talk about their private parts. Okay, what is private parts? In our body, some parts no one should see or touch, like chest, between the legs, and bottom. These are our private parts. Rule number two: if you don't like any touches, it makes you sad or scared, you tell to them stop or scream stop and run away from that place. Rule number three, tell an adult you get help from them. So first you want to say don't touch, then you want to say leave the spot quickly. Third one, tell elders like parents or teachers till you get help. Now I will see some safety tips to you. See, we have some safe zone persons. Who are these safe zone persons? Our father, mother, grandpa, grandma, brothers and sisters. They are our safe zone persons. You want to, remaining persons, if they are talking with you, just you want to keep some distance from them. So I will say to you some safety tips. First one, hey, everything to your parents. Especially mother. Don't share address or phone numbers to the strangers. Don't open the door without an adult present. Don't eat anything you get from the strangers. You want to learn some emergency numbers. These are the steps you want to follow. If anyone abuse you or hurts you, you call 1098 to get help. You want to call to 1098 to get help. The third one, have to help the differently abled person. See, when you are walking on the way, that time some visual challenged person try to cross the road. What do you want to do? You want to help to them to cross the road. You want to help to them to cross the road. So what is differently abled person? You don't use the word handicapped or disabled. Instead of that word, you want to use differently abled person. In Tamil, Matru Thiranaligal. So you want to give some help to them. How do you want to give? See, you want to ask first if they need help from you, then you follow their leads. Speak clearly. Listen their words well. Use direct words. Beware of their personal aids. So these are the things you want to follow. See here, Braille is a reading and writing method for the visually challenged person. It is raised pattern. They can be read with fingers. See, hearing aids. The person who lost their hearing capacity, they use the hearing aids. Sign language. who are deaf and dumb. They are using the sign language to communicate with others. You want to test what are the things we can help to their differently abled person. Open the doors for the disabled. Bring them to cross the road. Make them to wave. You treat as a normal person. Okay, you want to follow these tips. You want to follow these rules to help the differently abled persons. Our next topic is importance of physical exercise. So why do you want to do the exercise? Because the exercise makes our body fit and healthy. See, what are the exercises we want to do? We want to do running, jumping, playing, cycling, swimming, yoga. These are the exercises you want to do regularly. So what is the importance of physical exercise? Now I will tell to you importance of physical exercise. Physical exercise protects us from disease, balances our body weight, strengthen our muscles and bones, improves digestion, improves sleep quality, increases our energy level, improves skin health, boosts brain functions and memory. These are the uses of physical exercise. Okay, cuties. Now I hope you understand how to protect the sense organs, how to keep ourselves safe, how to help the differently abled person, then importance of exercise. Now we want to see some question and answers. What will you do when somebody who are not in your safe circle touches you? What do you want to do with them? I tell them to stop, scream, stop and run away. How do you help differently abled person? Bring them to cross the road, making way for them. Third one, say some tips for child. Have emergency phone number. Tell everything to your parents. Don't open the door without an adult presence. Question number 4, what are the uses of exercise? Balance our body weight. Improves digestion. It makes our body fit and healthy. Thank you children. You too follow these attitudes and rules. You enjoy your life. Thank you.